Hi guys, today I'm going to make a 1 kilowatt lithium ion power station using dead old laptop batteries. So the battery cells required for this project are 156, therefore it's 1 kilowatts. Now here we have the lithium ion batteries that we salvaged from the old laptop batteries. So it's time to check which ones are working and which ones are not. Dead. Dead. Working. Working. Not sure. So I'm not sure about these four. These are working and these two are completely dead. Now if we have a closer look on this piece, you see it's completely rusted and this battery is corroded. Well, this one seems fine, so it means that this battery might have taken down this one as well with it, because they are connected in parallel. So let's separate them and try to revive the other one. Yeah, these both are gone. So now comes my 3D printed cell balancer that I made in one of my previous videos. Link for the 3D print will be provided in the description. You can check it out from there. So here, as you can see, it's negative. This one is also negative, although we can see that there is some glue present. So we will have to remove it with sandpaper. It's fine now. So this is how it's going to look after you have completed the placement of cells. It's beautiful, isn't it? So let's charge it. At present, the cell voltage is 3.39 volts. Now to charge these batteries, I will be using my old computer power supply. So that's your supply. You see this black collection of wires. Take one wire, it is going to be ground, and the red one being your 5 volts positive. So to the ground wire, I'm going to connect two diodes in series to reduce the voltage from 5 volts to 4.2 volts, 4.2, 4.25, somewhere around that. And that's how I'm going to charge these batteries to full. And I'm also going to use this voltage ampere meter. Link for this product has also been provided in the description. You can buy it if you want. And guys, remember that this black wire will be left disconnected. Okay, so this red wire will be connected to the negative of your battery pack, and this tapping point red one will be connected to the positive. So at present the display is zero, because and you can see that there is some fluctuation. That is because the batteries are not charged enough to power it up. This runs at 4 volts, so I will have to power up my power supply. So here, as you can see, it's indicating 3.7 volts and the flowing current through the diode and the wires is 4.2 amps, and I'm charging 8 batteries at the moment. So after some time, here as you can see, the meter is showing 4 volts with an input current of 1.8 amperes. So finally it's fluctuating to 4.1 volts, which is good enough for the batteries. So I have to repeat the process with the rest of the batteries. Now guys, I've placed another set of dead batteries this time. Okay, and that's the meter, it's still not on. So here, as you can see, the open circuit voltage Now let's connect positive and the negative. You can see the meter just turned off because the voltage of the batteries is so low that it cannot even operate. Like the voltage from the power supply has dropped to the level of the battery, because of which this is getting like a voltage less than the rated. And now we are close to it. It is fluctuating. And here you can see that the drawn amps are as high as 8 amperes for 3.5 volts. That's a lot of current for lithium ion batteries. Battery is heating a lot. These two, only these two. I think these are like not so well. So now it's drawing nominal current, 4 amps. That is acceptable. But these two were drawing huge currents. So after completing the charge balancing part for the batteries, it's time to weld them together, for which I will be using my next 3D print. Link has been provided in the description. Next level. So guys, now that the positive side welding is complete, let's move on to the negative side. So let's test the battery voltage, and here we have 3.9 volts. So this is how we are going to use this 3D print for making our battery packs, 8 x 2, 16 batteries.